Matty, the repercussions of that defeat last night are still reverberating around the world. What has hurt fans, football fans in particular, is that Argentina, forget the loss, they didn't play as a team.
No, and we discussed this many times ourselves before the game and leading up to the tournament. You know, they had a complete shadow of an Argentina team of many years, individually and collectively also.
Okay, Marvio, I know you're a very good singer. You sang for us in Monaco when we were there for the Laureus Awards. Are you going to sing Don't Cry For Me Argentina on this show? Or are you going to tell us how Brazilians are so happy to see their bitter rivals struggling at this World Cup?
Well, on the music, please spare me from this cliche, Dick.
Are you gloating? Are you gloating there in Brazil? What's happening with Argentina?
No, actually, we follow Argentina with deep interest. We wanted to see them. Well, it's our rival. It's our classic rival. But we it's sad because when you see a giant going out, or close to going out, or in this situation that you can't see the team even battling. Argentina is not a team. It's very messy in a certain sense. Yeah, in all the senses, it's very messy. And you look at a team, you don't see strategy, you don't see articulation or organization. It's hard to see Argentina playing. And we know that this is a result of an administrative chaos that they have lived in this last 4 years, changing coaches. They had three coaches in the last 4 years. Hmm. They had Messi almost said farewell to the national team. He said that he didn't want to play anymore, and he only returned with Sampaoli. And Sampaoli is having a hard time trying to put a good team on.
Yeah, he may try to put a good team on, but it's not working on the pitch. Because, you know, I think that last goal summed up the mood in the Argentinian camp. It was pedestrian. They were sitting and watching while the Croatians passed the ball into the net.
Yeah, well, I mean, one of their most experienced players, Javier Mascherano, you know, each stopped twice. You know, just before the ball goes into the net, he actually stops twice. He's got his hand up to the official, and he's not even reacting, he's not even trying. You know, and that shows to me that even the most experienced players are giving up.
Okay, let's break this down for our viewers. Why Argentina was so abysmal, appalling, as those headlines say, Matty? Because you and I were having a chat before this game, and then we went on air last night. We were told they're going to play a 3-4-3, and you immediately told me it's going to be a recipe for disaster, they're going to get thrashed. Why did you say so, and what did you see in the match that convinced you that Sampaoli got his tactics completely wrong?
I mean, for me, if you just look at Croatia for starters, I mean, Luka Modric was key to that. And then obviously they have the two midfielders, Brozovic and Rakitic in midfield. From the start, you've got a 3-versus-2 situation in the centre of the field. Of course, Argentina with the back three, they're only up against one forward. But again, with two high, wide attacking midfield players on the right and on the left, you know, they are players that are able to isolate the wide centre-backs to get out. So that's the first point. The second point is that you couldn't, as Marvio said also, there was no strategy, there was no passing patterns, there was no structure to the way that they build up, almost as if they are expecting to just get the ball to Messi, as happens at club level sometimes, and for him to do something. But that didn't happen also.
Okay, Marvio, what's the talk there? Is there too much pressure on Messi, or you know, a player of his class has the ability, as we saw in the Brazil game, they found a way through. Is that the problem, that he's just trying everything, not too much support coming in? But the other way of looking at it is, isn't that the same thing which is happening with Ronaldo as well for Portugal?
No, it's different, because Portugal has the same coach in the last, I believe, 4 years at least. And they found a way to maximize the power of Cristiano Ronaldo. Now, when you see Messi, what happens to Messi is that he has to solve every problem that Argentina has. And you see Messi plays far away from the box. He's never that close. When you see Messi, he plays close to the box when he is in Barcelona. He's famous for that. He's not close. He has to pick the ball in the midfield, pushes that because the quality of his partners is very low when it comes to passing. Yes. That's the problem with Messi. He has to solve every problem of Argentina, and yet he has to prove to his crowd that he has a value.
Yes, and the people of Argentina.
This is too difficult. When you see Cristiano Ronaldo, when you regard Portugal was very happy of having the best player in the world, and that's it. When they have the European title, when they got the European title 2 years ago, it was like unbelievable. Mm. It was it was a bonus because they already know they knew that they couldn't dream a lot. With Argentina is different. They want to dream. They live that intensely, and Messi is frustrated. He's always frustrated because he can't give him a lot more. And make that team work.
Okay, they can dream. This is the theater of dreams. Is the problem then the coach? Because ever since he was appointed, he spoke about playing good attacking, passing football. We didn't see that. He departed from that philosophy, especially after that initial reversal. You look at his record, they've lost three times, all three times massive defeats, 4-2 to Nigeria, 6-1 to Spain, 3-0 here. Even their victories aren't exactly, barring one against Italy, but Italy by then had not progressed to the World Cup. So nothing much to write home about. This has not been a marriage of convenience as they were hoping it to be.
No, I mean, he's a top coach. I think he's having a bad spell at the moment. It's obviously his home country also. But again, they have a lot of talent in the team. There's also a lot of talent that didn't get on the plane to Russia, and I think that's playing his part also, specifically Mauro Icardi.
Mm. Okay, selection issues as well, talking Argentina. Well, on that note, I need to thank Marvio and Anjos for joining us from Rio.